Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Habati fillah, all of us in one form or another know people or are affected ourselves in our own lives with depression. And depression, it can come from a variety of factors. It can be from family issues that people face, financial issues, the stress. Some people are afflicted with drug addiction. Some people, in fact, you find from sinfulness. For the mu'min, the believer, sinfulness can cause a person to be depressed because they know they're doing wrong, so they feel sorrow and they feel sadness, and sometimes they carry that with them because they are struggling with a particular sin that they are fighting against, and that causes them also to be in a state of depression. Then there are those who are affected with this illness, if you will, on a temporary temporary state where they are affected with temporary depression. It could be from an event that happened in their lives, things are just not going how they planned or in accordance with how they want and wish, and that can cause them to feel a temporary state of depression. And without getting into the issue of mental illness, which is far outside of our scope as we're not professionals in that field of mental health, but from experience and from studies and from looking at the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are some ways to at least try to remedy and deal with depression. And one of the things that we have to keep is dua, because dua is ibadah. Kama qala nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ad-du'a huwa ibadah. That dua, supplication, is worship. And so by worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more, this can be a means for removing the difficulty from your lives, number one. And number two, it teaches you how to deal with the difficulties that are in your life, because we're all tested and we all struggle. The second point I want to make is that by making tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as the ulama mentioned, a tawakkul huwa itimad ala Allah wa fi'la asbab, that it is relying solely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, putting your affairs, putting your trust in all of your affairs with Allah while taking action, fi'la asbab. And we talked about this many times, that when we talk about tawakkul, for example, the one who wants their rizq to be increased, they don't just sit in the masjid and say, well, you know, I'm not going to work, I don't want to work for the non-Muslims, I don't want to do this, everything is haram, and I'm going to sit in the masjid and my rizq is going to come to me. Yes, your rizq is going to come to you, but that is not the way in which you search for your rizq, and that's not fi'l asbab, because you're cutting off from what is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that He provides according to His sunnah. His way is through people making effort, through people working. However, there are those people who are blessed that money comes to them in various ways, and through ni'am, blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we can't understand. But the general sunnah of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides, gives us our rizq, is through work and earning and doing business and making effort. All of that requires what? It requires fi'l asbab. All of that requires what? It requires effort. So with that being the case, that we need to make efforts. How do we deal that? How do we make a gem or how do we bring that together with the reality of our status, on how we deal with our affairs and our daily lives? How do we make that fi'l asbab? So this comes from the experience and the experience of professionals in their studies and in their efforts. And so a list of ways that we can put our trust with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making action. Number one, when a person is suffering from depression, one of the ways to help remedy that is to get a routine. Meaning, get some sort of activity that you do regularly to kind of distract you, to kind of perhaps even entertain you, and something you can find enjoyment in. And sometimes it's not just in and of itself that it's something enjoyable, but for example, someone who's bored at their home And perhaps they may need work. Work gives them something to kind of excite their heart and gives them something to look forward to. That can help lift a person from depression. It can help treat and remedy depression, and especially positive habits, things that you enjoy. Maybe some people it's basket weaving, some people it's reading books, some people it's water skiing, whatever the case may be, but find some habits, some positive habits. Number two, set goals for yourself. This is imperative, and I say this to the youth because the youth, you can see from a lot of their questions, a lot of the issues they face, they don't have goals. And a lot of us, when we were youth, we didn't have goals necessarily too, but it seems like the generations are getting more and more lost because of the things, the stimulus they're bombarded with, the lack of parental guidance, and all kind of factors to distract you, to make you just want to be lazy, and so many people want to be bums, in essence. So you need a goal. You need to have something you set your mind to. Yes, you want to utlub al-ilm and study. That's a beautiful goal. Also, you can have more short-term goals that you want to, for example, for the men and the women, perhaps you want to bodybuild. You want to get your body in shape, or you just want to be fit, or you want to be a little, you know, be a boxer. You want to be, the point is to have something in front of you. Something is a long-term goal in your life, and I say this to the youth, and I say this to the women, not just, I just want to get married. That's beautiful. Walillahi alhamd. But have a goal. Have a goal. In case it doesn't work out, I do believe firmly in tying your camel, so to speak. Preparing yourself for the best and the worst situation. Set goals for yourself. And this also helps you keep focus and your mind stimulated. And it is a treatment for depression, as those people from the Ahl al-Fen, the people who study these issues, indicate. Another point, and this goes with what I just said to a degree, is exercise, just physical exercise. Whatever it is, jogging in place, in your home, skipping rope, getting on the boxing bag, as I said, weightlifting, jogging, walking, whatever the case is, just that physical, because that physical, mental, spiritual connection, we are one. We are a spiritual being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us to worship Him in Him alone, and we're all connected. You know, we're finding out that our teeth health can affect heart attacks. That shows there's a connection. There's a connection between things which we don't normally associate with, you know, a person, how good dental hygiene, how that can affect their hearts. So it shows us there. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when he was talking about the heart, he said if the heart is corrupt, and this is talking about the spiritual heart, that if it is corrupt, then the whole body is corrupt. So it shows us that we're one, we're connected. So by exercising yourself physically, by physically, mentally, and spiritually being fit, this helps brings that mental status to help you correct and rectify oppression and fight oppression. And I tell you, for me, stress, one of the ways that I deal with it, one from amongst the many, and that's what I mean, you have options, is exercise. Sometimes if you, for men, that aggression, getting on the bag, and the gym. I like the gym. I like to hit the weights. When I'm in the States, I love to hike and just get out, be by myself in the fresh air. All of those things, they are outlets, and they help you deal with depression and deal with stress and all those things and negativity, and they help you remember Allah as well. Another important point of weight is eating healthy. And so I'm not going to extend on this, but if you can eat organic, I believe firmly. In my household, we try to eat as best as we can. We can't afford to eat organic always, but we try to eat healthy. We try to eat healthy. The things you cook with, cooking with olive oil. We use essential oils. I'm a firm essential oil person. I use it for so many things, and it's amazing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put so many cures and so many natural things. Hepatitis soda, you know, black seed oil, and all kind of things, prophetic medicine. I'm a regular honey. I'm a honey addict. I drink herbal teas. I've been doing that for years, and these things, the healthy living is very important. Also, getting sleep, which is something I do not have the luxury of, so I cannot even speak from experience, but I hope in the future to have a lifestyle where I can sleep appropriately, exercise appropriately, teach Islam appropriately, and أطلب العلم appropriately and go forward in my life بإذن الله and call people to the خير بإذن الله تعالى. Another important thing is actually by having responsibilities. And this can go back to the person having a job or when a person has a family, because what it can create in you also is a sense of accomplishment. We need a sense of accomplishment. When you graduate from school, that's a sense of accomplishment. I'm at the end of my PhD and I can't wait when I, you know, to be Dr. Green. That's just, it's an accomplishment. It's something that I spent years and effort, and I, you know, you feel good about that. That makes you feel good. You're human. You need to feel good. There's nothing, that doesn't contradict the shara. In fact, it goes muafaka ma shara. So you want to feel good about yourself. You want to accomplish goals. You want to accomplish things in your life, whatever it may be. Another thing to deal with the depression is challenging those negative thoughts. So all the negative thoughts that you get, when you think and you're going to give up on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you think things don't go good for you because you're having difficulty in your life, you just came from this test and another test, oh my gosh, a bill comes out of nowhere, a sickness in the family, a death in the family, something, you're getting tested, people find out about your sins, and you made Tawbah already a long time ago. Well, that's a part of it. And that's a part of the test because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you ease with your difficulty, and look to those beneath you because it could be so much worse. It could be so much worse. So thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show him the sabr in that, and he will increase you in khair. And by being thankful, he will give you more. So be of the shakirin and get rid of those negative thoughts. You're going to be negative. We're going to be depressed. We're going to have sad thoughts. The shaitan's going to come. Knock the shaitan in the head. No. I believe in Allah. Yes, this hurts me. Yes, I'm sad. Yes, I'm going through the struggle. I'm going to go bow down. I'm doing this rakatain, and it's going to help me. Ya Allah, put your heart with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and put your leave your amr with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Another important thing is try something new in your life. To deal with depression, try something new. Something wild. And that's what I like about when I'm back in America, where I'm from, especially Washington State. It's so beautiful. Just get lost somewhere. Hopefully you have a compass or something. But, you know, I love, you know, I'm going to try snowboarding in the future. You'll see. Bidnillah. I might take the camera too. Hopefully they don't break anything. But I've always wanted to do that. Okay? So, try something new. And that, you know, it's you need that. You're human. You need it. And I want to stress this to those. You said I want to stress it to the sisters. Try something new that's halal, you know, that you can do. You have to. You have to try something new and something positive. The last thing I want to mention is, if need be, seek medical advice. Because when you're dealing with depression and it's on a long term and it's something, but strive your utmost to stay away from meds unless your situation really necessitates that. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Anything I said that was correct was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.